What? See that Zoe, it seems like Kuzan having a pretty good time here in mid lane as we have a pretty hefty trade.
Yeah, Basebreaker comes down, the ignite is ticking, but no.
And that's just gonna waste a little bit of time for Kakao, who is down camp to Sejuani. Huh? Well. Flash used by Thal,
who
lost his blue buff, finds himself up a camp, up CS as okay.
Yeah, Tal looking for Rich here. Great knock up. Death's Grasp brings Rich all the way back in. No way that he can do anything. It's Kakao with the Jhin Air Flare once again. And Nova, max range on the Dredge line as Kuzan taking a lot of damage. Kakao. He knows that Beyond is here. Once again, Kakao waiting in the brush, but he just walks in and face checks. There's the Death Realm that goes down. So. See what Rich can actually do here. Beyond's gonna move on in. World Ender comes down, but Rich should still be dead. No! Moves underneath the turret, will survive for the meantime. And Beyond gets...
And... Okay, so...
What? Oh my god, he can't see him.
The ward's outside the brush, but I believe it's transparent, so I don't...
Yeah.
Understand.
Oh, wow.
Okay, well, that, all right, that now makes a lot of sense. So, he sensed that maybe something was up, walks into the brush.
Yeah.
And Beyond almost able to turn it around, but not quite.
Well, we were casting that, assuming that they were all starting off this Cloud Drake.
They rotated five members over. Wait.
Oh, Dan Chung just gets engaged on Kuga, makes his way into the pit. Emperor's Divide is huge, but the Azir is just dead. Two kills already. The Team Dynamics, whose team fights have been just so damn good. Tal now running away, and everyone is here on Dynamics' side as Kuzan gets over, steals Tal's flash, and Guga comes in with the Facebreaker. The Brambleback getting involved as well, as that is not enough shielding.
They pick up the Cloud Dragon for themselves. Let's take a look at this one more time. And take a look. At everything that happens, the Sejuani just getting such insane value here as well. Rich popping off.
He's just
on
really
the Zatrox again.
Dan Chung spots them out here, but I have a feeling they're not going to be able to do enough as five members of Dynamics are in the area. Beyond gets the turnaround ultimate. There's the Showstopper into the back line. Emperor's Divide does absolutely nothing as Rich is on top of Dan Chung and will put him in the death chamber. Kakao now out of this fight for good as Rich gets in on top of Sangyun. The Death Realm is in, and it's Rich fighting against Tal, and now Tal is going to be too far up in this lane. Going to get stunned up, the Facebreaker comes in, Guga even grabs the kill, as Trouble Bubble just barely misses onto Sangyun. And Dynamics, they move into this mid lane, they take down the outer turret, they should be able to get work done on this inner, and Shirley is going to have a really good time here, as Rich, just 12 seconds until that Infernal Drake does come up. And I think Sora will have one more chance for a team fight, and taking down Rich immediately is a good idea. World Ender has been parked here as stopwatch used by Kakao. FaZe down very, very low as Kuzan.
Yeah,
he has Death Dance as well, so that's going to help.
It's all about Zoe here and what she can do.
Oh, well, there's the Showstopper into the back line. Guga maybe going a little bit too early, but the Haymaker keeps him alive. Dan Chung picks up that first kill, but now he's taken down very low. Rich once again with a fantastic team fight. Kakao, Permafrost taken down. Tal's going to die just off the back end. And Dynamics looks like they just...
Really appreciate if you could just recognize him for the fashionista that he is. Well, see, if a team fight breaks out with the Baron buff still persisting, we could just see the end of the game. Okay.
Oh, wow, Sangyun. Has to cleanse to avoid that trouble bubble. And the Banshee's Veil is what he's going to get for his trouble. This inhibitor going to be taken down. 40 seconds until that Infernal Soul is going to be there. We'll see where the Dynamics move back to collect that one. The last ditch team fight is going to be happening now as Tal has teleported behind Dynamics, but there's a control ward there. He's just been met as he throws down the Death Realm. Now the rest of Dynamics are going to have to try and see what they can do. Beyond is there in the Death Realm with him, but look at the damage. The Showstopper gets Guga into the backline. Three-man Facebreaker. Immediate double kill from FaZe, as this will just be the end of the game. Kuzan flashing forward. Dan Chung down very low as he has to sit on his fountain.
That's
now.
It.
And Dynamics speedrunning the promotion tournament. This is likely a 24-minute victory, maybe not even that, as the next Nexus turret is going to go down. Rich flashing on top of Sungyun, has to flash to his fountain, and Dan Chung is now in the trouble bubble. 23 and a half minutes for game two, 26 minutes.
Starable will continue on now to tomorrow.
Yeah, you can see Beyond is so happy. And Rich as well gets back in, of course, debuted in the LCK.
Yep.
As Guga posing for the camera. And just absolutely overwhelmed is Beyond. 2-0, 2-0, very, very fast. I want someone to do the calculation of the amount of time spent on Summoner's Rift before promoting to the LCK. Because I think that this team would be up there as upside down classes Beyond.
I'm going to go to the middle.